Little ducks, there's trouble in Russia. So they called us. Oh, wait, sorry. I thought this was the opening of Crimson Tide because this episode actually takes place in Alabama. Go Bama. Hey, thank you for tuning in to another episode of A Toy Store Near You. Today's episode is about total nostalgia from Trinity, Alabama. The owners are Philip Dobbins and Renee Rivers Dobbins. This episode has it all, and I hope you dig it.
All flights are go as we head out to our next destination. Step out of the city and into the country to an off-the-path town bustling with character.
Oh, I'm very animated.
As we join two travel-bugged college sweethearts,
you start off hollow,
to take us down the rabbit hole wonderland of toys.
We actually get along really well.
If you're unsure what you're cruising for,
I've never been in a store even remotely like it.
Be ready to roll the dice. The clock.
We could just stand in here for hours.
And apparently all the tides you got.
You gotta get a roll tide.
For a look at total nostalgia.
In 3, 2, 1, Ireland.
Go.
What do you mean start with?
You were rambling on about how we met earlier. I don't remember how we met.
Okay.
I was probably drunk. That's a joke.
That's Marshall County for
you. But I probably was.
Just kidding.
I'm sure it was at a party.
Basically total nostalgia. Spread out over 3 units, packed with more things than you can look at.
It's almost like a museum and a music park. Just a little bit of everything.
My name is Philip Dobbins. Oh, we're not saying our last name. Well, you know, you're used to saying your full name. My name is Philip.
And I'm Renee, and we own Total Nostalgia in Trinity, Alabama. We are centrally located between most of the major cities.
It may seem like it's out in the middle of nowhere, but it's really not.
It really isn't.
Sadly, Trinity's a great place. But
there is nothing here.
There ain't nothing here. Outside of gas stations, we are the biggest retail place in Trinity.
We currently occupy 3 of the 7 stores in the shopping center that we're in.
The store takes forever to shut.
So our main space is 2 buildings put together.
So this is our main side right here, but the sports blah, 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 blah.
And then had to convert the one on the very end to hold all of our comics and vinyl records.
So we specialize primarily in 90s to current. We don't just do toys, we got video games, comic books.
I've been a collector since I was 16. I'm 23 now. My favorite thing I've collected throughout the years is Iron Man comics. I've got about 250 of the 322 run. Total Nostalgia's really helped me stay with it.
We like to say bringing back the good from your childhood, because you can walk into here, adults can bring their kids into here, relive their childhood.
Well, I had this kid. Shot my brother in the eye with it.
Yeah.
Kids nowadays, there ain't no KB Toys,
no,
there ain't no Toys R Us. They gotta go to Walmart.
Waste no prices.
So a lot of kids don't get the experience of toy store like we got to as a child.
The best part is when people walk in for the first time and you hear the holy cow. And normally when you come in for the first time, you end up spending an hour or two just walking around looking at everything.
I can spend hours in this place. But where does the majority of our money goes?
It's almost like a little
like a time capsule.
Time loop.
So let's crack this time capsule open and show what we've got.
Dude, I'm not even in the shot,
picture.
Man.
Get in the shot. This G.I. Joe Phantom X-19. Everything in this is sealed and it has never been played with. Still in its original plastic, basically brand new. I think this came out in 1988, during the time when Air Force was coming out with its own stealth fighter jet, and so G.I. Joe kind of did its own little concept version of it, but it's pretty cool. As old as I am.
But I'm older.
How we met.
How we met.
What we do.
I collected as a child, and I was a weird kid.
I was trying to think of that while I was peeing.
My dad convinced me to not open none of my toys. So I was big into Power Rangers.
Teenage Defenders of Earth.
Christmas, birthday, I didn't open anything. But then it kind of, you know, I got older, got into girls and all this other stuff. And it really wasn't until we started buying the stuff again that I got really big into collecting again.
2007, 15 years.
15, gonna be going on 16 years.
We've only been married for 1 year. Oops.
No, like a year and a half.
A year and a half. But I was 19 and she was 21 when we met.
Yeah. I was playing softball down at Sneed State and actually met Philip while I was living down there. And we have been together ever since. Lived in a lot of places together, traveled a lot together. We actually decided to take a RV trip out west. Lived in a 19-foot camper van with our two dogs for like 43 days.
43.
13 different states out west. So
states, yeah.
While we love the figure community, our real passion is always come back to travel.
Yeah, end game goals.
Even when we travel around, though, we're still always looking for collections to buy.
Yeah, we went to Disney 2 years ago. We came back with a 20-something-foot Penske truck loaded down.
Other than that, we're like everybody else in America.
We sit on the couch. We watch TV.
Yes.
Beer pong champion right here.
Oh.
Undefeated.
As long as it doesn't involve heights for Philip.
If you have not seen, what was that movie, The Fall?
Oh, God.
God, if you hadn't seen that movie and you weren't afraid of heights, you're afraid of heights now. Terrifying.
So before we opened the store, we both worked at my family's furniture store. Us both working there kind of gave us a real edge, yeah. Knowing how to run a business successfully, things to do, things not to do. Which luckily for us, we get along really well. Like we're very yin and yang, because I'm like the very uptight, stressed out one all the time. And then Philip just kind of goes with the flow, more laid back, and just constantly tells me to just, you know, calm down, don't worry about it.
I'm a stoic.
Yes. All right, circling back.
Hey everybody, we are going live to do the drawing for the autographed Stan Lee comic.
Yeah, people think going into business, I mean, it is fun, but they don't see all the hours that you put in your off days.
And even on days off, or even when they're closed and things like that, I mean, they're willing to answer messages. We see them out in conventions and they're, you know, they're always just talking it up.
Yeah, we might only be opening, you know, X amount of hours a week, but we're still constantly like 20 more hours a week doing stuff towards the store. At the end of the day, to know when you look back at your business, you've built a rapport with your customers that they love to come back to you week after week. If you're gonna be around each other 24/7, that's what you have to have, or you'll probably end up, you know,
divorced.
Well, murdering each other.
Or on Dateline.
We at a toy store near you would like to remind you that this is not one of those stories. But surely every story has to begin somewhere.
First started, I was getting aggravated with losing house. Dining room was gone, guest bedroom was gone, and after that, I looked at Philip and I was like, this stuff needs to get out of the house, because I got no house. I knew eventually I wanted to start my own business, didn't know what it was going to be. It just kind of worked out.
Got a bunch of Power Ranger stuff again. She collects aliens and predators.
Yeah. I've been signing a lot of cars on the store.
Jason David Frank came to our store to do an autograph signing.
Got like 50 things that are autographed by JDF.
He said bring all the things, and Philip did.
I wanted to be him. Death Star Commander? Don't
Death
you want
squad.
To command the Death Star?
Death Squad. Death Squad. Don't say star. It was squad.
Well, it was on the Death Star.
Nerds will yell at you. They'll be like, oh my
Nerd
god.
Nerd rage.
What you got on your boobie? Phillip's dancing. All right.
Sorry. Hold it up.
So another cool piece that we have here in the store is this 1977 12-back Death Squad Commander.
Prepare to target the main jet.
So there's actually six variations of him, and this one happens to be the shiny arms and suit pink face variant. They later changed it to the Death Star Commander.
Death Star?
Death Squad. Death Squad. I'm not sure why. He was sadly the figure that everyone had, but no one wanted to play with. So if you got stuck with him, with all your friends, it probably wasn't the best time.
All right, no need to get your spacesuit in a bunch. This store's got plenty of atmosphere.
What I like the most about this store, Renee and Philip are always smiling. The establishment's always clean, it's organized.
I'll let you start it and I'll just follow along. I'm gonna tag along like a little puppy dog. Our store is set up a little different. We don't have a big, massive location.
Eventually, it's
eventually,
coming.
Eventually, yeah.
It's
fingers crossed. Yes. But we are two stores in one shopping center. The main store down on the end, which is two units. This side over here that we're gonna show you right now, it is one unit. Comics are all down through here.
Probably about 160 long boxes or so.
Funko Pops, they are pretty much everywhere throughout the store. That's probably the most popular collectible, I think, right now.
My favorite thing I've purchased from here is this number 5 Funko Pop. It's one of my favorite Funko Pops I actually own from the 20, 30 that I have.
A wall art that's, again, overflow. And then our glorious record section. Yes, yes, we do have them. We may not sell a whole lot of them right now, but we do have them. So, all the fun things over here.
These are really cool. These are laser discs that we
framed. If you remember laser discs.
It's a video turntable that works with a laser beam, and that laser beam makes all the difference.
Was it early 90s? 80s, 90s?
Older. I'm sure they were in the 90s too. Yeah. I don't know when Laserdisc was a thing, but it was. Yes. This giant thing was your DVD.
And according to the experts, the picture blows videotape away.
More action figures, more Funkos mixed in.
You good old clamshell VHS.
Beauty and the Beast on video cassette.
These sell for like $5,000 on eBay, people.
Yeah, Black Label Man.
Yeah.
The Disney banned version.
I guess the more expensive comics, like more key issues on the wall. If you're a Bama fan like we are,
yeah.
Mosley.
Roll Tide. I don't think you can have people on a show from Alabama and not hear a Roll Tide.
Yeah, you gotta get a Roll Tide.
Yeah, yeah.
Go, Bama! Roll Tide!
This is like PlayStation.
Let's walk over again just real quick, because you turned your back and we're talking with your back turned to a
point. I thought we weren't going to stay stagnant right here.
Oh. So believe it or not, one of the things that we sell the most of on any given day
are stickers.
Who doesn't love stickers? Yeah. You can put them on virtually anything.
And you wouldn't think it. Temporary tattoos.
Yes.
Before you get inked, highly recommend get a temporary tattoo. Stick it on. See if it looks good. I've got 6 on my body right now that I wish weren't there. I should have went with one of those things.
Yeah.
All right, but no one tells Sergeant Reds.
So on to the next section of the store, which is...
My moonwalk. I can't, but I wish you could.
Sadly, no. This is where we expanded to once we overgrew the first suite. Anime, Pokemon, vintage Star Wars.
I wish I could find that one with that dude in the bathtub.
It's disgusting. It's not a bathtub. You're talking about this one.
Yeah, that's just disgusting. Why would you want that?
He has little rats that hang down into his cut-up in the belly. No McFarlane for you. He likes to do weird things. Of course, every store that you go into is going to have their glass display case. You never know what's going to be rotating out of this whole section.
And then we're in Alabama, so you gotta have your redneck Christmas tree that stays up all year long.
All those unwanted McDonald's toys and Imagine X and all those, we take and we turn those into ornaments and people love them.
Some mask over there on the wall. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah. I cut her off. I do that a lot when we're walking around trying to do this filming.
Phillip's a hand talker.
Yeah. Rick and Bobby.
Possibly in the near future.
I'm doing it again. I do it every time. It's one of my favorite moves.
Yes.
I'm not sure what to do with my hands.
Should I do it where it's like sitting to side and like bring it into frame, like bam? I can take them out. So the most valuable piece we have in our store is this 1993 TMNT Scratch figure. So Scratch was from the comic books. It was thrown into some toxic waste and mutated.
So the best, most recent collection we bought was all those carded turtles.
Yeah, it was like 240 carded turtles.
Sadly, your pizza offer will be invalid.
That's where that Scratch came from. Got a hot spot. It was an insane collection.
Yeah.
Insane collection is a bit of an understatement, which means it's time for a turtle roll call. Kickbox and Leo, Pizza Tots and Rat, Space Usagi, Dingus Frog, Wacky Walk and Mouser, Creeper. Crawl and Splinter, this guy, and Anthrax. And Trax. Well, that's a little on the nose.
So we both...
Hold on, you need to like pause it, reset yourself.
When we were very first getting started, when we were still buying out of our house, we found this website where you can buy these like storage units online. And there was one in Atlanta, and you don't know what's in there. You hope that it's all... toys and comics, but I ended up getting 3 first appearance of Harley Quinns out of it. I said, dude, this dude.
Yeah.
We want to be the mecca, not just for toys, for pop culture, because we pretty much will buy anything that you could be like tied to pop culture.
I mean, obviously everybody's gonna butt heads from time to time.
Yeah, when I'm like, don't buy that, and he buys that. And then I'm like, I said, don't buy that.
Yeah, that happens, but it always works out. I make good decisions.
One of our other cool pieces that we got in the store here, carded Hasbro Bret the Hitman Hart. The best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. If you watched wrestling in the 90s and you didn't like Bret Hart, well, I don't know what's wrong with you.
From the historic WWF Hasbro action figure series, Bret Hart, hailing from Alberta, Canada, made his action figure debut in Series 4 back in 1992. The excellence of execution, the master of the sharpshooter, best there is,
the best there is,
the best there was,
the best there was,
the best there ever will be,
the best there ever will be.
Multiple time heavyweight champion in countless organizations, this figure is the definitive Bret Hart collectible. I wish I had one. Now the figure's worth like $400 carded, and I'm not dropping that kind of money.
So another one of our favorite pieces is this cool Anakin JCPenney display thing right here. He's super cool. He's life size. He stands on this cool little rock thing with a very faded out plaque.
They auctioned them off after the movie, and somehow we ended up with one here. They were limited to
275
of them. So very limited edition ones. Wears real clothes, his glasses move and everything, but the way we have him set up in our store when people round the corner and aren't paying attention, it will scare them and you'll hear people kind of be like, one of the cooler pieces in our store is definitely him.
And he's got real rooted hair.
Yippee! I love coming in and seeing them. They're always so happy. Hey, let me show you this, or look what we found that you might like. She's great.
Tennis up Forbes.
They will host toy swaps.
We've met a lot of people through the store. We hang out with everybody a lot.
It just gave me something to do, places to go.
We try to treat everybody.
It's not cool to be treated.
It's always been awesome just coming and speak to them, bantering back and forth.
Subscribe to our OnlyFans.
And pretty much everybody that comes in here is such interesting, cool people that, I mean, you can't help but be nice to them all anyway. If you wanted to be mean to them, you probably couldn't.
We even had some action figures made of ourselves, which are really awesome.
On Jew Toy Store, where the owners have their own action figures.
But we have just fantastic customers. I mean, they're amazing.
We need more firepower, Renee.
And just their knowledge, too. They have a really wide knowledge between the two of them. It's been actually impressive.
They even help correct us on like how to pronounce things if we don't know how.
Death Squad.
What about the golden rule? You know, treat everybody like you want to be treated. That's pretty much our philosophy.
Yeah, it's the best one you can have.
And that's a childhood lesson once taught to Philip by a mighty hero.
I remember we were actually at my dad's, and I had gotten a phone call from a number I didn't know, and I listened to that voicemail. It was Jason David Frey.
Guess who's back?
I had a heart attack, and I went running outside, and I was like, Philip, listen.
He was going around to local comic shops, toy stores, and at the end, he got a percentage of what he made in autographs and pictures to the actual store to, you know, help them get through the whole COVID thing.
Yeah.
And it sucks that he passed away this November, so that was really rough for everybody in the Power Ranger community. That was definitely heartbreaking here. Because he was just, he's such a nice guy. Grew up watching Power Rangers, and he was always my favorite Power Ranger. In fact, he's the main thing that I personally collect is just Tommy stuff.
Never really thought when I was a kid, when I got my first Power Ranger figures, that 20 plus years later, I'd have a toy store, let alone Jason David Frank came out to the store, who was my childhood hero.
He's definitely gonna be missed.
Oh yeah.
For sure.
The collecting community is some of the best people, it seems like. They would, you know, give you their last dollar. If you needed it, they would be there for you. No questions asked.
I've known Renee and Philip for 3 or 4 years now. This poster was one of the first things in my collection that I got. I had a lot of family trouble, so I ended up having to sell off my collection, and I sold this to Philip. One day I was just able to come back in, and I asked him if he still had it. He's like, yeah, it's been tucked away in the back. He stored it for 6 months, not having to, and he allowed me to be able to purchase it back from him. My wife, she said if I'm gonna have something that big and that expensive, then it's gonna hang in the living room. I was coming to the store, you know, once or twice a week, and then it started getting to where I was watching the store, going over to their house and having game nights, party nights, eat breakfast in the morning. They've grown so much, and it was really great to see them and watch them grow. I'm really proud of them for everything they've accomplished.
You want me to hit you a beatbox?
Yeah, drop me some tunes. I'm gonna rap about Tim. I ask this all the time, you know, I don't know how y'all work together. I can't stand being around, you know, my significant other just when I'm at the house. And I'm like, you know, I can't really see it any other way of not working together and not being there.
Mm-mm, not at this point.
No. So I don't know if it's like codependence now on each other. Probably. Being there.
Well, through enduring teamwork,
I need a shot.
Renee and Philip have truly built something built to last. And whether it's the great outdoors or great toy indoors, Total Nostalgia can rely on one thing.
It started with a level of trust, with a good foundation. They'll always have my support.
And that's a money-back guarantee valid wherever you go.
Oh, come check our store out. If you haven't ever been, you need to come look at it. It's probably the greatest toy store around. For sure in the Southeast. I haven't been to all of them, but I'm going to go out and say it. It is. Trinity's number one power couple. You're looking at them.